Okay, compare linear and quadratic models. And here we have square granite slab weight versus side length. So the side length in feet is kind of like the input of the function here, and the weight in pounds of the slab is the output. So if you have a side length of 2 feet for a square slab, you would have a 2 foot by 2 foot or 4 square foot section. Okay, and I want to compare linear and quadratic models. So let's take a look at a linear model first. Now we know linear models have a constant rate of change, so that means if you were to subtract these outputs, and as long as they have a constant difference here for the inputs, notice that you're adding 3 each time for the inputs. In order for this pattern to work, you need to have a constant rate for the inputs. That means there should be a constant rate for the outputs. So if you're adding 3 each time to the inputs, you should be adding some number each time for the outputs in order to have a linear model. So I'm just going to do these differences real quick. So 450 minus 72, and you could use a calculator if you wanted. I'm just going to do by hand here. So 378. And then the next one. $701. Next one. $1,028. And then the last one here. $3,526 minus $2,179. And all I'm doing is I'm looking at the rate of change pattern. $1,347. So as you're adding 3 to the inputs, the pattern for the outputs, well, you're not adding the same number each time. Look at the differences. I mean, first you add 378, then you add 701, then you add 1028, and then 1347. Obviously not a linear model. But you know what? There's a pattern with a quadratic function for the second differences, meaning you subtract the differences. So this can be a good test to see if you have a quadratic function or not. So let's do 701 minus 378. Okay, so we got 323 here, and then 1028 minus 701. We got 327, and then let's try 1347 minus 1028. We got 319 here. Now, if you compare these second differences, they're almost the same. And they're not exactly the same, which, of course, in a real-world modeling situation, the numbers don't follow an exact pattern. But usually, if they're at a pattern, it's pretty close. And it really looks like this could be a quadratic function because these are the second differences. And that means you find the difference between the outputs first, like you would a linear model, but then you subtract those differences. And if the second differences are all about the same, then you could have a quadratic model. Okay, now I'm going to show you how to do a quadratic model on a calculator. So what I did is I went ahead and inputted the data already. And for a calculator like this one, you press stat and then 1 for edit. And then you can see you have L1 and L2. So you just get over in L1 and you list all the inputs of the function. And then for L2, you list the outputs of the function over here. And then you're ready to do your modeling. And we already said that the quadratic model would be better for this situation based on the second differences, so that's what I'm going to calculate. So I'm going to go to Stat, and then right one to the Calculate menu, and I'm going to choose Quad Regression, which is option 5. That will fit the data to quadratics. Okay, so here's our function. And the A, B, and C are given here. And look at the R squared, 0.99999. That's an extremely strong correlation. 1 is a perfect correlation, so you know you're on the right track here. So it's going to be 17.0 And don't be afraid to use a few decimal points here. So I'm going to do 17.976 x squared. And then plus 0.281x. Then minus 0.695. Okay, so here's the quadratic model. Y equals 17.976 x squared plus 0.281x minus 0.695. So just for a comparison, let's look at a linear model. Stat, calc, and then lin regression, which is 4. Okay, and you can see here the R squared value is 0.95, which is still really strong correlation, but the thing is, if you were to graph this along with your points, it wouldn't fit the model as well. So what I mean by that is, you can go to your Y equals, and then actually turn on your stat plot, and then graph, and it should show some of the points if they're in the window. These ones obviously are not. I'm going to change my Y max to 3,000. Be a good start. Okay, then you can see the points here. Try 4,000. And let's put the X max. Greater value. Try 30. Okay, there we can see all the points real nice. These are the data points for the function. And if we use a linear model, if you notice there's a real nice curve, it really looks like half a parabola here. So if we use a linear model, it won't really represent the data, but the quadratic certainly would. I'll just go ahead and type that in there so you can see. Plus 0.281x minus 0.695. And graph. Okay, look at that. See how the right half of the parabola goes right through all those data points? That's like a perfect model there. So you can see here a quadratic model is really a good fit here. And if you'd like to get the linear model in here too, you can compare that. So let's go back and recalculate that linear model. So it's y equals 287.9 minus 827.6. So I'm just going to round it a little bit. Y equals 288x minus 828. Okay, and then you can see the line doesn't miss the points by much, but it doesn't represent the data nearly as well. So the quadratic is definitely the way to go here.